we have 25 volt.
There is no display.
5 volt for the meter are missing.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. This is our second video on this inverter welding machine. In last session, we detected that its power LED was flashing. It was not turning on. The fan was turning on, turning off. Low voltage power supply was fluctuating between 0 volt and 7 volt. It was not maintaining 24 volt power supply in this section. We detected that its IGBTs were damaged, short circuited. When we disconnected those IGBTs, the circuit started its power supply. And now we have another problem. The display is not turning on. There is no display on the meter. If you don't have good experience in electronics, never try to repair. Because here are unisolated live voltage. Always take care for safety and never touch in front side any heat sink, any component, or in rear side until we are confident that there are no voltage on this capacitor and it is disconnected from the power supply. If there are voltage on these capacitors, we will verify using multimeter and we will discharge it. After complete satisfaction, then we will touch the circuit. Let's start. I applied power using series lamp and now I will turn it on. Yes, now it is powered on. We have 25 volt.
There is no display.
5 volt. 5 volt for the meter are missing. There are just only 1.5 volt. No 5 volt. We need to check this 5 volt regulator. 7805 regulator. Yes, it is not providing 5 volt. Input okay, but no output. 1.49 volt. Four volts. Now it is discharging. That regulator is here, and here is capacitor. That is this regulator. Five volt. This common. Here is input. Yes, here is visible bubble on the body. I will use this 7805. DC voltage. Now I applied power and we will check it now. Still there is no display. Now we will check it again. Yes, it is also dropped. That means this ampere meter is damaged. This ampere meter is damaged. We have 5 volt. That means its meter is damaged. Still this regulator is safe. Yes, it's gone. This IC is damaged. We need to replace this meter. I have a meter for other model type, so I will change the wiring for this one and then we will check. Five volt ground in this model, pin number 1 DC 5 volt, pin number 2 ground, positive 5,
ground. Signal in. Ground in, ground 5 volt. Positive 5. Ground. Ground. Signal. Now I soldered the wires to use this meter. This is for another model. Its wiring is different than this one. So I removed its connector and I soldered new wires as wiring connection. This one, 5 volt ground, in and ground. This is measurement signal and these are supply voltage. And its pinout is different. Its 5 volt supply is in this side. Positive 5 volt, 0 volt, return and signal. And its input signal is here. Its ground is at last end. So I changed the wires. And now we'll check it. Now let's see result. Yes, the meter turned on. Now I will set current. Yes, it is setting current. It is 600. It is measuring 550. Yes. Now it is reading full scale. So now it is displaying full scale current because it is arc 600. It is showing now 600 here. Until now we verified its original meter damaged. That caused to damage 5 volt regulator. I replaced 5 volt regulator. I replaced the meter. Now the circuit is responding. It is showing the current. In upcoming session, we will verify the function of this control card and we will check its working. And we will also verify the pulse forming network, that is pulse transformer and its driver circuit, because its IGBTs were damaged. If IGBT is damaged, that time we must verify that gate drive components, pulse transformer, its diodes, rectifiers, the resistors. If anything is left unchecked, that will be a big reason to damage new IGBT. So we will continue in upcoming session. If this video is informative, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.